Are you ready for Sunday school, kids?
Yay! Good morning, boys and girls, and a very happy Thanksgiving to you and all your family. Thanksgiving is such a special day, and we celebrate it, of course, with this guy, with the turkey. We have a wonderful roast meal, and we enjoy that special meal of roast turkey, lovely vegetables, great desserts, and all the trimmings. But Thanksgiving is about giving thanks. And yes, we know that's important. When someone does something for you, you say thank you. But you know, sometimes when we say thank you, we just feel, because it was so nice what the person did, it's just not enough. And so we seek to do something else. Maybe we will write them a thank you card. And here's a homemade thank you card. And it's especially when it's homemade and you send them this thank you card. Sometimes even more special if it comes in the mail. But sometimes we want to do even more than that. We want to do something in return, to do something which will benefit that person who's been so kind to us. And you know, God has done so much for us. Probably no one has done more for us than what God has. God provides us food when we're hungry and water when we're thirsty. He heals us when we're sick. He comforts us when we're sad. And the Bible tells us that he is ever-present helper in times of trouble. So wherever you are, God is there to support you. But because of all God has done for us, we say thank you. But he's done so much, I have an idea to do even more to thank God. Jesus told us how to do it. Jesus said, "Whatever you do for one of the least of these brothers of mine, you do it for me." That means when we feed someone who is hungry, it is the same as doing it for Jesus. When we visit someone who is sick, it is the same as doing it for Jesus. When we give clothes to those who are in need, it is the same as doing something for Jesus. And when we go and cheer up someone who's lonely or maybe being picked on at school or who's not in the in crowd and we spend time with them, we're doing that for Jesus. And there is a special name for this way of saying thank you. It's called thanksgiving. Thanksgiving. Thanksgiving is when we show our thanks by the way we live. Thanksgiving is when we look at the many ways God has blessed us, and we thank him by sharing his blessings with others. So let's just pray. Dear God, we come into your presence with thanksgiving. Help us turn our thanksgiving into thanksgiving. Help us notice people around us who are in need, and ways we can care for them, like you care for us. In Jesus' name, amen.
Hi, welcome to God's Garden. We've got some really cute Thanksgiving table decorations for you to make today, because we're all going to be having something called turkey coming up pretty soon, and probably some family will come over, or you'll go over to your families and celebrate all the wonderful things that we've got from God that we can say thank you for. So the first one we're going to do is we're going to make a turkey like this one. And you'll find this on the activity pages. If you go to the church's website, you'll find a picture of this and the directions too. And I'm going to show you how to do it as well. Okay? So what we're going to need is some construction paper, because we're going to start to make the back feathers like that. So you're going to need 4 pieces of different colors, whatever color you think a turkey would like to be. Then you can do whatever 4 colors you like. And then we're going to also make the part that has his head and his body right in the middle here. So you're going to need some brown for that. I'll show you how to do that. We're going to need 2 little hearts cut out of red, and those I'll explain to you as well. A little tiny orange beak and 2 woggly eyes. If you don't have the woggly eyes, you can just draw them on. All right. So I'm going to start by showing you how to do the body part. So on this one, you're going to have to get some brown paper, just a small piece, and fold it over like this. Then you're just going to kind of draw a head and go down to the body. All right? And then you're going to cut that out. And if you're cutting it on the fold, then you only have to do it once, and both sides will match, which makes it a little bit nicer. The next part is you're going to fold the bottom just a little bit. Okay. Now we're going to put what's called a wattle on the turkey, and that's the red part that goes under his chin. So I've got some glue here. Think that maybe that's where they keep all their vitamins, so that when they're not able to eat, they have those extra vitamins there. But nobody really knows for sure what it's for. And then we have the comb, which we're going to put on the other side, but we're going to just put the heart on the back of the head, so that we only see the top spumpy part of the heart, and that's the comb, and that's always on the top of the turkey's head. And then we can put his beak on. You know what beaks are for, of course. So I'll put a little bit of glue for the beak and two for the eyes. And then we'll let that dry while we're making the rest of it. Okay. And one and two. Okay, I'm just going to set that aside for a minute. Like that. You know how to make paper fans, I'm sure. So that's what we're going to do with these. We're going to just fold them all back and forth. I'm going to put these on my turkey dinner table. And I'm going to put somebody's name on each one. So I'm going to make one for each person in my family that's coming. And it might be this one, or it might be the next craft I'm showing you, so that you can kind of alternate around the table. See which ones you like. And then you're going to take your pan and you're going to fold it in half and put a nice deep corner on it there. Hold it tight for a second or two. Okay? Then you're going to take what I've already started here. I'm going to put some glue across the whole side of the top right here, across, in my case, it's the purple one. And then I'm going to glue the orange one on top of the purple one. Okay, slide it in there on top and make sure it's even like that. Oh, look at that, it's getting better and better. Now I'm going to take the red one, and I'm going to do the same. If you're going to make one for each member of the family, you could get somebody in your family to help you do it. Make it a family project. Everybody helps to make the crafts to decorate the table. Your brothers, your sisters, your mother, your dad, your grandma. I'm sure your grandma would like to help. All right, so remember the next one, we're going to fold it in half. Put a nice corner in there, hold it really tight. Okay? Now we're going to put some glue on the orange one so that we can attach the red one to it. If you want, you can put a little staple in there to hold it tight if you want. If it's a little bit tricky for you, but because we just have to wait for the glue to dry. Then since that's the last one, we're going to join those two together. So I'm going to put a little bit of glue on the last of the red one here. Just need it on one side. And join those two together. And there we have the turkey's feathers. Okay? Then we're going to use this now, and we're going to use that fold and put some glue on the back of that fold, and put this part here, because this is going to go underneath the feathers. So you might want to put quite a bit of glue to make sure it's going to really hold tight. And then that goes underneath, and there is your turkey for your Thanksgiving tape. He's falling down there. So there's the number one prep. If this is falling down like mine is here, then a little bit of glue on the back would help hold it up as well. So just put a dab of glue there, and it'd take maybe a minute for that to dry. There's our turkey decoration number one. All right. The second one is really kind of fun. Well, that one was too, but this one's fun too. We're going to make a pumpkin. We're going to make a Thanksgiving pumpkin. And on this one, I have the leaves on top, which says, I am thankful for. And then on each side of this pumpkin, you're going to write something that you're thankful for. And then that could go on the middle of the table, and everyone can see all the things you're thankful for. And then you can read theirs as well. So to do that, you need some orange paper. And you're going to cut it in about 1-inch strips. And you're going to need 4 strips for each pumpkin. Okay? I've already cut out some strips. I'll just do 2 of them here. Okay. You're going to need some green paper to make the leaves on top. You're going to need a marker to write with, and some glue. So what our goal is to make a star shape like this. So we're going to glue them together until they're a star shape like this one. So to do that, you just need a little bit of glue in the middle of each one. So to make it even, I like to do a cross first, like this, and then do the X part on top of that. And that will make it pretty even for your pumpkin. And a little bit more there. And a little bit there. Okay, now comes the part you have to think about. What are you thankful for? It can be anything that's happened this whole year or in your whole life, things that you're thankful that you're so lucky and fortunate to have, and that God is in your life. I have done some on here. I am thankful for the warmth of my home. I'm thankful for my health. I'm thankful for Canada and for being safe. And I'm thankful for my cat, Misty. And I'm thankful that I am able to help others. And I'm thankful for my faith and my children. But you can think of anything you want that you are thankful for. The next part, you're going to lay it down with words on the bottom. And just one by one, we're going to glue the top parts. So remember, we did it in a cross at first. So those are the ones we're going to do the first this way. And then the ones that cross over the top of it. So a little bit of glue on here. And the one that's crossed over the top. A little bit of glue. Come back on this side. Okay, so now we just have the X part left. And we'll do that one by a little bit of glue. A little bit of glue. So if you can't write the words of the things you're thankful for, maybe you could get your mom or dad or older brother or sister to help you with that part. And there we are. Now the last part is to put the leaf on the top. So I like to fold things over when I have to cut 2 of them, because it makes it so much easier if you can do 2 at the same time. So I'm going to fold it over just like I did that one, and I'm just going to cut any kind of shape leaf that you want. I put little jagged edges on mine. You can do any kind of leaf that you want. If you have a pumpkin with leaves on it, you can look at those leaves and see what they look like. So now when I open it up, I have 2 leaves and enough space to write, I am thankful for, on my leaf. That's what I'm going to do right now. I am thankful not going to write for what on here because the four whats are already on there. One more little dab of glue. And we've got our pumpkin ready for the table. So there we have our two Thanksgiving table decorations. And I hope you have lots of fun doing those and encourage your family to help you with them because we're thankful for you too. And you're thankful for them. Let's work together. Our song today is about how thankful we are for everything that God has given us. And this is kind of a fun song. The tune is from a song when I was a teenager called Rock Around the Clock. And your mom and dad, I'm sure, might know that one, so maybe they can help you sing it too. There are some places where we are going to clap hands in this one. So if you see this, that means one clap. And there's another one, says one clap. Here, after the word amen, we're going to do two claps. Two claps. And then this one at the very end, we're going to say amen. Pause. And then two more. Okay? Here we go. God is great. God is good. Let us thank him for food. We're going to thank him morning, noon, and night. Going to thank him because God's out of sight. Amen. Amen. Amen.